Yes, now with that, let us move to the second example. This is all related to first example, right? So next, let us move to the second example, which is x2 of t. We will take it to be e power a t u of minus t. Okay, and if you try to plot this function, how does it look here? Because u of minus t is there, the signal will be on the left side of the y-axis. So, and for this to be absolutely integrable, the plot of the signal should look like this. And when will this happen? When will this happen? This happens only if a is greater than 0. Okay, and what is the equation of this curve? It is e power a t. Okay, so if a is positive, then definitely it is a in negative direction it will decrease, or in positive direction it will increase up to 0. Okay, right. So x2 of t is defined like this. You can easily see that this fellow is absolutely integrable. But what happens if a is less than 0? If a is less than 0, Fourier, this fellow is not absolutely integrable, and hence if a is less than 0, Fourier transform of x2 of t does not exist. Okay, now let's assume that a is greater than 0, and hence x2 of t is absolutely integrable, and hence its Fourier transform exists, and it is given by integral minus infinity to 0. Why? Because of u of minus t, correct? E power a t multiplied with e power minus j omega t dt. So this again would be equal to integral minus infinity to 0. Okay, I will write it as a minus j omega t dt. Okay, so this you can simplify, and because it's an exponential, you get e power a minus j omega t divided by a minus j omega. And what happens to the integral limits? It is minus infinity to 0. Okay, so I'll keep 1 by a minus j omega out. So if you substitute 0, you'll get e power 0, which is 1. Correct? So if you substitute 0, it is 1 minus, if you substitute t with minus infinity, what will happen? A is positive, keep that in mind. So if a is positive and t is minus infinity, so totally you will get e power minus infinity, which is equal to 0. Okay, so you will get how much phi as the final answer. So this should be equal to 1 by a minus j omega. Okay, so the Fourier transform of which signal? E power a t u of minus t will have what as Fourier transform here? So this signal will have x2 of j omega, which is equal to 1 divided by a minus j omega. Okay, right. Next, so as usual, let us write this fellow in terms of real and imaginary part. So let me write down that we have got x2 of j omega to be equal to 1 by a minus j omega, which is equal to multiply and divide with whom now? A plus j omega. So you will get a by a squared plus omega square plus j omega divided by a squared plus omega square. How did we get this here? We multiply and divide with whom? A plus j omega. So clearly, what would be the real part? So this implies xr of j omega is equal to how much? A by a squared plus omega squared. And similarly, I'll take 2 again. And xi 2 of j omega would be equal to omega divided by a squared plus omega square. Okay, right. So similarly, what happens to the magnitude? Magnitude of x2 of j omega, as usual, this looks like 1 by z, and hence modulus of that would be 1 by modulus of z is square root of a squared plus omega square. And what about the angle here? Angle of x2 of j omega would be equal to tan inverse of imaginary part by real part. Imaginary part is how much? Omega by a squared plus omega square. And the real part is how much? A by a squared plus omega square. So what will happen? A squared plus omega square will get cancelled, and finally you will get tan inverse of omega by a. So angle of x2 of g omega is tan inverse of omega by a, and absolute value is 1 by root of a square plus omega square. Now again let us take few examples here. Yes, for this example, again this is a sub example. Okay, find CTFT, correct? So find the CTFT of, so first signal let us take e power 3t u of minus t. So clearly this is looking like what? This is looking like e power at u of minus t, and for Fourier transform to exist, a should be greater than 0, which is satisfied, and hence what is the Fourier transform? 1 by a minus j omega, that is 1 by 3 minus j omega. Okay, right. Next, second example, let us take e power 2 plus 3j multiplied with the t u of minus t. So will this fellow has Fourier transform? Let us check. So for this signal to have Fourier transform, it has to be absolutely integrable. Means what? Integral where? Because of u of minus t, you will have minus infinity to 0 modulus of e power 2 plus 3j t dt, which is equal to integral minus infinity to 0 modulus of e power 2t multiplied with the e power j 3t, correct? Modulus of e power j 3t dt. So with the same argument as we have seen before, so modulus of e power j 3t is how much? This fellow is 1, and this integral would be equal to integral minus infinity to 0, because modulus of e power 2t is same as e power 2t, will retain like that, multiplied with dt. So you can easily see that this is equal to half, and because this fellow is less than infinity, the given signal will have Fourier transform. So and what is the Fourier transform? Fourier transform would be 1 by a minus j omega. But what is a here? It is 2 plus 3j minus j omega. So this should be equal to, I'll write like this, 1 by 2 minus j, I will take out, so I'll get omega minus 3. So just for clarity purpose, we'll write like this. So 1 by 2 minus j times omega minus 3. So that would be the Fourier transform of this signal. Okay, right. So similarly, we'll take two more examples as we have seen before. Third one, let us take e power minus 2t u of minus t. Okay, will this fellow has Fourier transform? No. Okay, so no CTFT. I will leave it as homework to check why. Why? Because you have to check whether this signal is absolutely integrable or not. If it is not absolutely integrable, you can say that he will not have Fourier transform with the same argument. So what will be the, what about this signal? Minus 4 minus 2j. Okay, into t u of minus t. So what about this signal here? So this signal also will not have CTFT. Why? This fellow is also not absolutely integrable. So because I have put a question mark, you have to check. Okay, please check whether these two signals are absolutely integrable or not. If they are absolutely integrable, it will have Fourier transform. But as I said, there is no CTFT. They should be not, they should be absolutely not integrable. Okay, please check that. Okay.